Hello everyone, in this video, we'll learn how to monitor a Cisco switch using Zabbix through the SNMP v3 protocol. This is a secure and efficient way to collect and monitor key information from your network device. Before we get started, make sure you already have a working Zabbix server set up. If you don't have one yet or aren't sure how to install it, check out the video below where I walk you through the full setup process. Your Cisco switch also needs to have SNMP v3 configured in advance. If you're not sure how to do this, please check out the video linked below in the description for a detailed guide on how to configure SNMP v3 on a Cisco switch. Alright, now let's go back to the Zabbix interface and start adding the Cisco switch to the monitoring system. From the left-hand menu, go to Monitoring Hosts. Next, click the Create Host button to create a new host, where we'll configure the details for the Cisco switch we want to monitor. In the Hostname field, enter either the actual hostname or a recognizable name that helps you easily identify the device you want to monitor. Next, in the Templates field, click Select to choose an appropriate template for the device you want to monitor. In the Template Groups window, select Network Devices to display templates related to network equipment. Here, select the Cisco IOS by SNMP template. This is a pre-built template designed for monitoring Cisco devices using the SNMP protocol. Next, in the Host Groups field, click Select to choose a group for the device. Here, choose an appropriate group to categorize the device. This will make it easier and more organized to manage and monitor your system. Next, in the Interfaces section, click Add and select SNMP as the interface type. In the SNMP field, enter the IP address of the device you want to monitor. This is the address Zabbix will use to connect and retrieve data from the device via the SNMP protocol. Next, in the SNMP version field, select SNMP v3. In the Security Name field, enter the SNMP v3 username that you previously configured on your Cisco switch. This is part of the authentication process that allows Zabbix to access and retrieve data from the device. Next, in the Security Level field, select AuthPriv. Select SHA-256 in the Authentication Protocol field. Next, enter the authentication passphrase that you previously configured on your Cisco switch. Next, in the Privacy Protocol field, select AES-128. Next, enter the privacy passphrase that you configured on your Cisco switch. Once all the required information has been entered, click the Add button to save the host. At this point, the Cisco switch will be added to the Zabbix monitoring system. After adding the host successfully, you'll see the device listed. Initially, its status will appear gray, which means Zabbix hasn't yet received any response from the device. After a few minutes, if the SNMP v3 configuration is correct and the connection is successful, the status will change to green, indicating that the device is now being monitored properly. Now you can view various monitoring graphs related to the device, such as network traffic, CPU usage, memory, and other metrics. And that's it. I hope you successfully set up your monitoring and get the most out of Zabbix. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you won't miss any upcoming tutorial videos. See you next time.